We will start our problem with a horizontal line. Then, from the left side of this line, we will pull another tilted line. And on this tilted line, we will put centers of three identical circles that are touching at the single point, as you can see on the sketch. We will do this in such a way so that the intersection point between our two lines is touching the arc of our left circle and that our horizontal line is actually tangent to our right circle. Now, let's have a look at the circle in the middle. We will use the chord, which is formed by a horizontal line, as a base to form an isosceles triangle whose apex will be located at the top of the arc of our circle, as you can see on the sketch. Now, the question is, if we know that the area of all three circles is equal to 25 pi, can we somehow calculate the area of this red isosceles triangle? This problem was sent to me by an email from one of my subscribers, Roger from Ohio. So thank you, Roger, for this wonderful suggestion. So we can solve this problem by using a geometry, trigonometry, or analytical geometry. There are really multiple approaches. But you guys can pause this video right now if you want to try to tackle this problem for yourself, and then come back and check the solution. All right, so let's solve this problem. So, as I said, there are multiple ways to solve this problem, but in this video, I will use geometric approach. First, let's label the centers of our three circles as OP and Q, and let's also label the vertices of our isosceles triangle as A, B, and C. And finally, let's label the intersection point between our two lines as D. Now, let's say that the radius of one of our circles is equal to r. We can easily find this radius by using the area of a circle of pi r squared. Since we know that the area is equal to 25 pi, we can cancel pi and get that r squared is equal to 25, which means that the radius of one of our circles is equal to 5. Of course, since all three circles are equal, this means that the radius of the other two circles is also 5. Now, let's have a look at the circle on the right, and let's rotate our radius vertically to the tangent of our circle. We can label this point as E. Now, we know that the angle at the point E must be the right angle. We know this by using tangent of a circle theorem, which states that if we pull a radius to the point of tangency, the radius will always be perpendicular to the tangent line. So we can use this in our case here. Now, let's have a look at the circle in the middle. And let's rotate its radius vertically down, as you can see on the sketch. And we can label the intersection point with the line AB as F. Now, since our radius is vertical and the line AB is horizontal, this means that the angle at the point F must be right angle as well. And finally, let's rotate the radii of all three circles in such a way so that they are in line with the line DQ, as you can see on the sketch. Now, let's focus our attention to the line BF, and let's label it as X. Let's try to find the length of this line. You will see later why this is important. But first, in order to get to the line X, we will take a look at the right triangle DEQ. And let's just notice the acute angle at the point D of this triangle. So, if we isolate this triangle, we can see that its height is equal to 5, and its hypotenuse must be equal to the sum of all radii along the DQ line, which is 25. Now, let's have a look at another right-angle triangle, DFP, and we can isolate this triangle as well. You can see that it will have the height of x, and the line DP, which is equal to 3 radii of our circles, which is of course equal to 15. Now, since those two triangles are right-angled triangles, and both of them share the same acute angle at the point D, this means that their third angle must be the same as well, so those two triangles are similar. Now, we can use the rule of similarity to find x. We can say that the relation between their hypotenuse and their height must be the same, so we can simplify the left side a little bit, and then we can cross-multiply to get that 5x is equal to 15, which means that x is equal to 3. Now, let's go back and take a look at the chord AB. From this chord, we can conclude that the segments AF and FB must be the same. But how do we know this for sure? Well, we will use one interesting property of a circle, which states that perpendicular to a chord, drawn from the center of the circle, bisects the chord. And, as you can see, this is exactly our case. Since the line PF is perpendicular to the chord AB, and it goes from the center of the circle, this means that it bisects our chord, so AF must be equal to FB. Now, finally, if we take a look at the radius of our circle in the middle and rotate it to the point A, you can see that we have formed this really nice right-angle triangle AFB. So, we can easily find the length of the line AF by using the Pythagorean theorem and say that the leg AF squared is equal to the hypotenuse AP squared minus the leg FB squared. Of course, you can calculate this, or you can use the fact that this is a classical 3-4-5 right-angle triangle, so we know that AF is equal to 4. But if you are a newcomer to mathematics, and I know that a lot of guys on my channel are, I will leave you a detailed instruction how to calculate AF by using the Pythagorean theorem. Alright, before we continue, if you enjoyed the video so far, I will encourage you to leave a like or subscribe to the channel if you already haven't. Now, we can easily calculate our chord AB, which is equal to AF plus FB. Since AF and FB are equal, this means that this chord is equal to 4 plus 4, which means that AB must be equal to 8. Now, let's have a look at our wanted isosceles triangle ABC. And let's rotate the radius of our central circle to the point C. If we do this, this radius will form a straight line from the point C to the point F. But, again, how do we know this for sure? Well, we can just use the property of an isosceles triangle, which states that if we pull a height from an apex of the isosceles triangle, it will always be perpendicular to the base and it will always bisect the base. Remember, in our case, AF is equal to BF, so our line bisects the base, but also, since this is an isosceles triangle, this means that it must form the straight line from this point, which is equal to the height of this triangle. Now, it's pretty easy for us to find the area of this triangle as the half of the product of the base and the height, so we can just substitute our values for AB and FC, which equals the 64 over 2, which means that the area of our wanted red triangle is equal to 32 squared units, and this is our solution. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel if you already haven't. Of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section below. And again, as always, until next time, see you all and take care.